alone with the love of a life. Sad to see a new horizon slowly coming into view. Yeah, I wanna be living.
Starting to keep it real, you are so fun. On a day like that, when I'm about to get a little blood in a tracksuit and some sneakers, and he still hands up, you hands up for real. You ain't got all dressed up. Absolutely. With all that you've accomplished and everything that you've done, let me just tell you, as a radio person, thank you so much, because you didn't have to come and hang out with us in Detroit.
Those people that are listening and those that are here in the audience today. It's been like 5 years I've been here in Detroit, you know. So I'm sort of looking forward to seeing everybody, you know, doing what I did.
All right, and you got a lot to do. Ron Isley's in Soul Session. We've got your music right now. It's Ron Isley. Everybody make some noise with me. Conversation while the music is playing, and we'll come back after this record. Let her know that. I asked you when I talked to you by phone a couple of weeks ago, what is one of your favorite records? First of all of your music is my favorite music. Every last one. Is it possible that you have a favorite? Do you have any music that when you sing it, you say, this is my jam right here?
Songs, you know, when we were doing slow songs like Living
with
What? Hello, it's me.
Yeah!
Make me say it again.
Right.
You know, it's a song, it's an according to what mood you
have as a
people. When you hear certain song, you know, that song, you know, would be like.
Harvest of the world.
All the songs bring back so many memories.
So
put your deaths in the dark.
You don't have to people in this room as a result of footsteps. You know what I'm saying, Ron. You know, thank goodness that most of these men in here, they ain't had to say a word. They just put on your music and let you do their thing. With you and R. Kelly come about, because you introduced yourself. My daughter's over there, she's 15, and when she came into the studio with me today and we were talking about your music and she started singing your songs, that's a whole new generation of folk.
You're right.
Becoming Mr. Big.
Yeah, well, his mother was a big fan of ours, you know, and she sang like Aretha Franklin. And so he came up on our music, and he introduced himself to me, and he said he wrote a song that he wanted to do it. He wanted us to do it together, and that song was "Download." And so we did it. After doing that song, we just became. Wait a minute.
Mike is a comic, Ron, and he sings too. Did y'all know that Mike about to sing?
No.
No. Because what is this song where they go back and forth? I didn't know you said. Yeah, you're contagious. You're a friend of mine. That's right. Y'all give Ron Isley another round of applause. Now tomorrow night, you're gonna be on stage with your brothers.
Yeah.
And you're gonna be on stage with Gladys Knight as well.
Yes.
You gotta give Gladys some love.
That's right. Gladys, we have I love working with her, you know, because, you know, we go back so many years.
I'm sorry.
And you know, Aretha Franklin will be there too. That's one of the awesome.
We put a couple of records together. One of the records on my album was nominated for a Grammy Award. And in her album, we did Memories.
To get with the legends and sit like this, but the biggest joy is that you allowed our audience to be a part of this afternoon. Yes. Now, Ron, talk about your relationship with Aretha Franklin. We're so excited that she's doing better. You said that your friend is coming to the Fox tomorrow night.
Yeah, you know, we've been friends ever since I was 15 years old.
Wow.
And she was about 14. So. When she first started, we were singing, gospel songs and so forth. And when she came to the Apollo Theater, it was a club there in Brooklyn called the Town Hill. We met each other. That was when she was 15 years old. And we've been friends ever since.
Wow. I know you guys, especially like in the 60s, 70s, the 80s, when it was popping.
Oh,
yeah. I know you guys had fun. Can we talk about some of this?
Yeah.
I mean, because you know what? And to me, and you know, I love the music that's out here. Your relationship with R. Kelly is what just not revived, it just gave you the experience, the opportunity to do something even better. So I got great respect for all the young artists and all of that. But let me just tell you, ain't nothing like seeing a band on the stage like you see Rhonda. And to see a group like the Isley Brothers. And you know what? I can't wait for you to walk out on that stage. I just want to know what you're going to wear.
I'm trying to think of something, you know.
Probably. You have always been a dapper gentleman, I must say.
That's right. Thank you.
You're absolutely. Can you at least tell us what color you're thinking about wearing?
Well, you know, I'm probably wearing about three or four things.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Right there. Three or four things. Ron Isley is my guest. We're in Soul Sessions. For those of our guests that are in the room, make some noise. We're in Soul Sessions with Mix 92.3. It's so great. We have Ron for just a few more minutes because I know that you have some other things that you're going to be doing in the city. And so we wanted to thank you again for coming out and joining us. Now, how long is your show?
It's 90 minutes.
90 minutes. So you guys are doing everything.
We have more leftover to do. But in just 90 minutes, we'll be doing that.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. Like you got a question.
90, that's an hour and a half, man. Oh, bang it. You're gonna sing this stuff from back in the day, that's new school stuff.
Man, we usually would want to do 2.5 hours.
Wow. Yeah. Now, are you guys still traveling?